This is what made them what they are. Write this down. Know why you do the work that you do. That's number one. Why you do what you do. I don't do this for money, but if you're going to pay me, give it to me, and I'm going to give it to my people. We're going to Robin Hood this thing out. As long as I'm alive and you're going to pay me millions, we're going to put some kids through school. I took 20-some kids to Dubai. You know why? Because when I went to Dubai and I got to the hotel and I looked around, I didn't see us. I said, oh, no, we're going to Dubai. We're going to Dubai. I'm going to use this to get some kids to Dubai. We're going to the Super Bowl. Why? Because everybody else at the other cultures at the Super Bowl, but my babies. I said, when y'all get there, do what everybody else do. Run around, touch stuff, hold field stuff. Go have a good time. Don't nobody be telling nobody, don't touch nothing. Get out of here with that. Everybody else touching stuff. Everybody else flying and living their best life. We got to go to the Super Bowl in a single file line. Bro, no, go buy stuff. Go get the hot dog. Somebody say, you know how much that costs? Ain't nobody else tripping about how much it costs. Everybody else in line buying it. Go get a hot dog. Get two. We went to Dubai. This little kid was like, we went to go eat. My man was like, I want an A1. Me and my wife didn't go. Praise God, my wife is doing fine, but she has MS, so we have to balance it out. So we had been on the road all year, so we didn't go. So a little man called and was like, the train ain't letting me get what I want. I was like, train, what's going on? He was like, he want an A5 steak. I said, okay, what's the problem? He's like, it's $250. I said, okay, what's the problem? It ain't your money, it's mine. Get a boy an A1. I said, are they selling A1? A5, is they selling? He's like, yeah, they selling, but it's 250. I said, get a boy the 250. Why? He from the west side of Chicago. They used to go into jail and die. Get a boy an A5 in Dubai, so when he come back home, he'll read like he ain't never read before. He'll go to school in the way he never want. Why? Because when he tastes that A5, he gonna want another one. The second one on him. I'll pay for the first one. The second one on you. You're going to have to figure out how to get back to Dubai and get that A5. Huh? But they going to do it if we give it. Number one, know why you do the work that you do. I know why I do the work that I do. So when little kids watch me and just want to mimic me, it's not going to work. You got to have a certain spirit to do this. This ain't a gift. This is a calling. This ain't a skill set. This is a why. I was planning in 2023 to be what King was in his generation. That's my job. That's my role. I drove here. I ain't got no bodyguard. Somebody say, hey, where's your entourage? Bro, you know how much that costs? I'm good on that. I could buy kids books for that. First year in college, anybody got time for that? The work I'm doing, I don't need nobody walking around me. I got my wife. She gangster. I'm good. I promise you, she gangster. I'm good. You ain't even gonna get close before she say something to you. Are you hearing me? Number two, know who you doing the work for. I'm changing the whole world, but I know exactly who I'm doing it for. I'm just gonna blow your mind. I didn't become number one because of us, okay? Let's make that clear, okay? When you look at my numbers, the followers is white males between 25 and 40 who are in the sales business. That's who listen to me. So that's where I go and I get 200 grand from corporate. Okay, y'all missed what I said, amen. Amen. Now, I love doing that work, but that's not who I do it for. Everybody getting blessed from it, but I know who I do it for. I'm doing it for the kids who don't have. Does that make sense? So number one, know why you do the work you do. Number two, know who you're doing the work for. And number four, do me a favor, stay focused. All right? This is the thing I love about Malcolm. That's why I love Malcolm. I love them all, but I love Malcolm the most because Malcolm, you couldn't even play and pretend like he was doing something he wasn't supposed to do. Malcolm, they never said Malcolm committed adultery. They never said Malcolm wasn't true to Elijah Muhammad. Malcolm walked that walk. He talked the talk, but Malcolm walked that walk. The third one is you gotta stay focused. Once you decide to do the work, you gotta stay focused. Number three, stay clean. As much as you can, stay clean. You gotta stay clean. I don't know if Martin did nothing wrong, but you know they gonna try to, 30, 40 years he gone, now they trying to say he did something. They got FBI, but got him on some voice message. We ain't even got pictures. But they gonna try to always tear your character down if you're doing something positive. Stay focused. Stay focused on the goal. Stay focused in school. Kids be telling me all the time, I've worked at Michigan State. My grandma not doing good. She got cancer. I'm about to leave school and go by my grandma. I said, you think your grandma wants you sitting by her bedside for 3 weeks and dropping out of school? What you gonna do for your grandma? You ain't no doctor. What you about to do? Go home and let grandma see your face, kiss her neck, and get your boy back to school. Stay focused. You can't do nothing for your family dropping out. You about to leave a big bill. At least graduate and be able to pay the bill off. Ain't nobody cash you out. Your grandma don't want you sitting there at her bedside. Stay focused. Oh, God, I feel depressed. I'm going through it. I said, how many kids is depressed? I try to figure out why they so depressed. They got more than we've ever had before and they depressed. I'm like, what are you depressed about? And then I went to the Instagram. I was like, oh, you depressed because you're looking at how other people live. Oh, I get it. When we was growing up, everybody on the block had the same stuff. We all had the same big wheel.
Right.
I'm just being real. We all had the same big wheel. We all had the sticks and was racing them jokers in the rain. We was all... We was all hopscotch. We was all watching our cousins. See, I met a man next time, man. Y'all depressed because you're comparing yourself. That's why you so depressed. You looking at what everybody else doing. You trying to keep up with everybody else. Huh? When we went to school, you went to school with the shoes you had on. That's it, period. So y'all gotta do me a favor. Y'all gotta stay focused.
What up, what up, what up? It's your boy E.T. Flight Assessment 2.0. Look, I love the assessment so much that it took me to a whole nother level. Like, I'm telling y'all, y'all think I've always been here. I promise you, there was a time I was lost. I'm just being real. There was a time that I was just shooting. I didn't know what to aim for. Like, I didn't know. And so I wasn't making the money I'm making now. I didn't know, y'all. I had a gift, but I didn't really know what the gift was. I didn't know how to use it. I remember struggles in my marriage because I didn't know who I was, struggling with my kids. So the flight assessment was phenomenal because it changed my life. It gave me a sense of clarity that I never had before. Like, it showed me my value, and it showed me, like, how to market my value, how to understand my value, how to sell my value, like how to put a price tag on what I was worth. I didn't know before. I was watching other videos, watching other people, mimicking other people, trying to do what other people were doing. It didn't work, y'all. And then boom, this assessment showed me. Now I'm gonna be honest, while I love the assessment, it was on some PhD stuff. Like, it was like an advanced degree. So I took the Flight Assessment 2.0 and simplified it for you. Flight Assessment now is a pilot, a flight attendant, a ground crew, air traffic control. Like, I simplified it with symbols and words that you can understand so that you can immediately take it and boom, and do something with it. You're going to be able to use it immediately. You're gonna figure out who you are, why you tick, what you do, and then you're gonna be able to, boom, take who you are and what you do and put it in the marketplace and make money. Listen to me very closely. Not only are you gonna figure out who you are, you're gonna figure out who everybody around you is, and guess what? You're gonna slow life down. You're gonna slow the game down, and you're gonna be able to do and be and have stuff you've never had before. So do me a favor, listen to me. In 15 minutes, your whole life is gonna change. Like, I revamped the whole thing. I made the investment. I studied this thing for 5-6 years. I studied you. I got it, y'all. I got it. It's gonna take 15 minutes. And in 15 minutes, you gonna know you like you've never known you before. You gonna have resources. You gonna have the people that's gonna be able to help you. You gonna be able to go, be, do, have everything you've ever dreamed of. You gonna speak with clarity. You gonna move with clarity. You gonna think with clarity. You gonna write with clarity. And that clarity is gonna open up doors that you never imagined that could be open. Are you hearing me? So I went from a YouTube sensation to the number one motivational speaker in the world. So I want you to do me a favor. Act right now. Don't think, don't overthink, right? Make the investment. Don't spend no money, make the investment. You're gonna get your money back. Click the button, register, sign up, and do me a favor. Bro, I promise you, when you do, after that 15 minutes, you are about to make the rest of your life the best of your life. It's your boy E.T. The flight assessment has revolutionized my life and my family's life and my family's coming life. Let it revolutionize you and your family to come.